So, can you kick your dad, please?
No.
It was your mother asking, so that should be fine.
Okay, fine.
Looks like we're all here.
Excellent. Buffs going, pots going. So pretty much for the benefit of Kieran and Shangri, then a lot of this stuff we just cleaved down. There's only a couple of things that we actually ended up CCing in the end. The little things, the little ones that run around have quite a big aggro radius, so try and pick them up, like these things in front of us here. Try and pick them up before they get body pulled. Other than that, that's pretty much it. Just fly through this part, to be honest.
Remember, if you want to skip this one, you have to dismiss pets as they pull. I report the smaller guys anyway, on the down south.
So really hook right, Kieran, quick, because I was going to pull.
Yeah. Sorry, man, I'm just
suck up,
some UI up.
Suck up totems as well. Is it you, Room? Suck up your totems.
Can't ask Guft.
Just be careful when you get to the top that the patrol's not there. Alright, we can run into this. Kill the Leviathan first. Cleave off the rest. Let's go. Just bring it slightly back so we don't get the patrol.
If you're melee, don't stand directly behind or in front of the Leviathan. Like dragon stuff, basically.
I don't like this debuff.
I can't track that one if you can tell him.
What's the debuff do?
Reduces healing by 50%.
Is it really that big of a problem going from 5 HPS to 2.5?
What?
Lol. Owned.
That's just rude. Like, I don't want to have to do maths.
Rest of that, buff them, and then we can pull the next patrol. Yeah, I'd also like some water, please, Majors.
I need a blessing. I keep getting south, I think I need kings instead of them.
Oh, there's one at the back here anyway, table now. If we can click. Thank you. Alright, let's run into this. I should grab the little boys on the left. Right, up the ramp. And I might just grab the patrol.
They will probably pull with the thing, kill them first, because they will heal the big one.
Pull, 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 pull. Kill the little ones on the left, then interrupt them as well. Kick them as much as you can. The back guys on Marcus will cross.
Would be nice if you could just pull them into the AoE. Shit, instead of killing them outside.
Oh, they have to be
don't
sent.
Fear them, okay. Thank you.
Do such a thing?
Yeah, oh, Mark, sorry. Sorry.
Hmm.
quite a lot of damage, this thing.
Yeah, it's like the hurricane, I guess.
That's all we're still in. So you just raid him with Katuva? Feels bad, man.
Katuva was the best.
Abu and Kenya. Remember last time, when you tried to sleep these turtles, does it work or not?
I mean, we just didn't do it, I believe.
Yeah, that's what I thought. hang on.
Can try to sheep then.
The setup was a little bit different the last time we did it of the group. Pretty sure we wanna kill Hydra first on the left.
Yeah, cause pack first. Actually, I guess the pack straightforward is has some random seats, because I remember there were some. There was
one less turtles and more casters. So. Yeah.
There was also elemental ones in it. So.
All right, Moon is yours then, Mimic, okay?
We do the.
Sorry, let's take left side left. First, yeah.
Wait, what am I hibernating?
Doesn't matter. Next pack, I say. All right, let's go. Cross on me. Torn up.
They're immune.
Ah, rip. And then you want to Anixia these Leviathans, right? As in, have them stand side on. Cool.
Who was tanking the green one?
Shangri.
Does Shangri agree with that?
The debuff that the green one puts on you reduces all your damage by 50%, so Fred is a little bit scuffed. I'm pretty sure that Tally's pet pulled aggro.
Correct.
Just to make sure it's turned off the taunt of the pet, because that's probably on by default.
Correct, it's off, yeah.
We can. Sorry.
At a certain point, there's Ascensia tanking, but he was not doing a good job.
Exactly. I mean, I was doing a really good job. I held aggro. The other problem was later on.
Do you still want to poly them or just take them?
So, Mimic, you're hibernating the turtle on the right, yeah, the moon.
Okay.
Cool. Just keep it hibernated. Keep spamming it. Oh, you can sheep them. Cool. Just add the other turtle to the cleave, it should be fine.
But we'll get this pulled anywhere, probably.
It's fine, you can probably leave it now. Yeah. Yeah, the turtles really hit hard.
Really good healing.
Don't tell him that, Karen.
No, that won't prove good. Yeah, I would take a lot of damage then.
Okay, can we find a way that people don't stand in stupid spaces when the healers can see him?
Yeah, what we can do is we can pull the boss back where we are right now, because there's a lot of open space where we are, as opposed to tanking him between where we are now, where people can stand, and then there's the pillars, which might line of sight. So if you want to do that, we can do it. Yep. Or we can just force everybody to walk behind the two flags, basically, which will also negate any line of sight issues.
I think that might be a bit difficult for space.
Let's get these lords first, anyway.
Okay. I'd say put them back. It's more space to spread out here, and I can see everyone.
Let's do that, then.
Turn these away, shall we? And then the spawns as well, that they randomly come up, just keep them stunned. Don't let them cast the Sludge Nova thing. Stun that, anyone?
You can kill the Aquarius Lords first, but you still need to pick these spawns up because they're killing the healers otherwise.
Yeah.
You can do softies like the things like blinds on them as well.
Yeah.
Just try and tank it where the corpse is then, like here. And then melee will stand behind it. Or you can turn it around, I guess. It doesn't really matter.
Okay.
Can you repost the macro very quickly in the engine? That's it.
Find it.
So, yeah. Yeah. Alright, so stay at yards and pick up the spears. Break the bubbles when I say please. Shango, you want to take this one?
I think, yeah. Rodaro was here last time, right? Yeah.
Well, it's actually some Randy Andy that did it. Alright, Radari, tank it then.
Yeah.
Ready whenever you are, I'll pull MD.
5. Four, three, two, one. You
will die. Let him get into position first, guys. Just spin it as quickly as you can.
I spin it?
No, don't spin it.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Are we moving it back to where
it was? Melee, split out better. And you need to pull further back, or else Melee might send behind the corner.
Spine out of Cal. Who's got it? Who's got the spine?
Spine, I think. Your success was.
On alien now.
I have it.
Alright, shield in 5 seconds. I'll tell you when to do it. Okay, we're gonna do it in 3, 2, 1, now. Use health stones when it breaks.
Yeah,
Kevin. Yeah, careful on your threat, Shango, as well.
People are standing with the guards of other people.
3, 2.
Top of all run first.
Okay, go. The next one. Should he really have one more and then that's it?
Did people hero already?
I was about to say, if you've got heroes, I'm using now.
We are running on fumes now.
Grab it out of slay, Pinky.
I have it.
Cool. Another shield in 8 seconds.
Cut off people now.
Make sure you're using health stones, everything. Okay, shield. 3, 2. Top off Marius. Go.
Using. Your success will wow La Magica. Hellstone should be up from the first one.
Nice just kill it now. Go out of town. Don't click town in melee range. That was harder than last time, right?
Correct me if I'm wrong, but we're supposed to stand 8 yards away from each other, aren't we?
6 yards. Range?
6 yards.
You should have a notification on TBM.
Some people were stood on top of each other there.
Oh, right.
Like, for the whole thing. Which obviously makes more healing needed.
Yeah, like I was like, once the shield is up, you just bandage. There's no DPS to be done. Like, there's nothing stopping you from bandaging, unless you're full HP.
I feel like that was a lot longer than last time.
Yeah. Definitely was. I think you have less than 8.4k health.
I think that was when I got combat vest and the stamina buff.
Okay. Alright, this pack here is pretty tough, so Kieran, you just go in AoE, stun as much as we can. Obviously let him get a threat, but then just like nuke him.
You could buy some cleansing totem as well.
Did you bubble pull this or you did it?
No, I didn't last time.
No.
That's good. Yeah.
Yep.
Do you want to wait for a good camp, by the way, or take the Enon Shaman that's looking for a temple?
Send as much as you can, guys. Man. Try and peel stuff off the healers. Can I say how long it'll be or not?
No. So I'll just...
Okay, just grab this guy then.
Can I relog real quick?
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of this stuff we just walked through last time, so literally just when you're ready, Kieran, pull it on the right. The little ones have no health at all, just kill the big one.
No MDs,
yes, yeah, it's because just behind.
Summon this guy in the meantime. Salarogian. So these ones here social the big guys as well. So it's all gonna come basically.
Could move them over to the big guys.
Yeah.
Just clear.
So you can take them underneath. Got the pack on the left coming to us at the back. And maybe MD trap it to you, Kieran.
Everything here seems to be taunting me, so...
Yeah.
I foresee a lot of Warlock steps.
Can somebody, maybe Saul, can you give the park permission to join this shit here?
Yeah, he's not joined, yeah, is he? Rest the dead, buff the dead, and then next pack. These Fearbringers just turn them away.
Probably want to wait for the Dragon Caller shit first, I guess, I don't know. Actually, you can maybe take this guy here.
Yeah. I'll pull him back.
Then again, the other guy is coming back as well, so it's unlucky timing.
I'm just gonna engage these flyers. No, no, no. Alright, get the guards. We need to be fast on this. It's not the end of the world if we pull the other.
We're probably going to engage with the Fearbringer as well.
Yeah,
here as well.
Just turn him around and take him out. Move out the rain fire.
Frost no wet.
Getting the other one will be bad. Like the Fearbringer guy. Just go.
Need to move out of the rain.
You think I have that shit keybound adjuster?
Can we just wipe it? Like, this is fucking horrible.
Yeah, just reset, just die. Okay, we should take this a bit slower then.
You don't have escape artist keybound?
I mean, I have all the way over at 8, but I was shadow building. Trusting my healers. I used to play as a part of you guys.
Objectively a bad decision to trust us.
Objectively a bad decision to trust you. I would gladly trust my life with a jester.
Well, that worked out fine.
Yeah, not
wait
this
for
time.
The worm callers taken back.
I see aggro range on this stuff.
And if range get aggro on the dragons, they need to move away so they actually drop to the ground, else melee, including tanks, can't do shit. So you just have to tank them, basically. They don't do much damage, but at the same time, we won't do any damage to them.
You just want to bring them away back.
And what do you think the chances are for a pull? Oh, the enhancement chamber was close.
I think, in practice, we're going to take the Fearbringers first.
You run back in, don't run too far to the left, there's still two Aqueous ones there.
Should be able to summon. Ailu, if you can start summoning people at the back. Let's get off Sky and go again. Alright, let's get buffs out. In a second I'll pull the Fearbringer here. All we have to do is just turn that way. So everyone else stay back for now and I'll grab it. Yeah, you can outrange it as well. And yeah, the AoE stun you can't outrange. We got the rain of fire.
You had to move his tank then as well. That's my level, just eat it. You had to move.
Grab these ones in the middle now. Actually, I'll grab the riders, and then we're just going to bring them back. So the further that you bring these back, the closer they get to the ground, so everyone else can actually hit them as well. So if you get aggro on them, just bring them way back. So Zenzia, they just come back.
I'm so far away right now.
This looks like it's bugged in the wall or something.
Probably.
Inbox reset. Maybe. Excellent.
Note nice. To self, don't listen to soul. I ran away and.
It was because I was like,
run
on the
run on the powerful way, yeah, don't run over the.
Alright, come in now. Should be able to kill these before the other things actually arrive. And they're already on the floor as well, which is good. Be ready to pick up the Fearbringer if it comes, but it probably shouldn't. Cool, much better. Alright, next on this guy on the left, we'll move up to him. I don't care about here, it's fine. Use the fire, guys. Yeah, the one in front of us here now. Just quickly on the boss then, so we're going to take the left side first anyway, and the right side dragons. Phase 1, Kieran's going to tank it. Move it when you can, Shangri. Phase 1, Kieran, you're going to tank it pretty much where it is now. There's not really much to phase 1. Let me just check this.
The only thing to mention apart from the... He's working like patchwork. Shangri staying top 3 threat, basically. Soaking.
Yeah. Let Kieran pull these.
Buff some Avagon, please.
I want this pack of tea to go away. Or...
No, that's fine. Just grab. Like these little packs are really nothing. Put them a little bit more back for the chat. I just want to. You can even pull them without the Taskmaster. I think the Taskmaster just gets angry when you kill his slaves in front of him. Yeah, get these guys, the dragons now. I'm bringing them back.
Linked with the rum colors as well, I remember. In the back, I'm right now.
Yeah. So if you got a girl on the worms, just keep bringing them back. Is it Jaina or you?
Rum colors, Cleave as well. Don't face him to the woods, right?
See if you can run back a bit. That shit's on me. That's not on you. That's not on me.
Okay. Highly interesting gameplay.
Yeah, might want to like designate somebody to be the one that gets them down, like gets aggro on both of them, like a range. Oh. Before anybody starts damaging them, otherwise we're never going to get them out of the air.
Let's see that here then. I'll grab the cross. I'm just gonna run it back. So just don't do anything for the time being, just wait.
Tanks still pick up the wrong colors.
Yeah. It's fine, like, the healer's gonna aggro, but that's fine. This is on the floor. And there's like little orange shit on the floor, move out of that too. Cool, nice job.
I mean, the question is if you want to try and tank them. By a tank, like having to move down, or just have the range deal with him and have it handle like a random DPS that goes on the raid while the melees finish off the worm color.
Let's see, last one here. They're already pretty low, anyway. There's one, only one worm color as well, that's cool.
Maybe melee just learns how it feels to be useless for a bit.
Yeah. Care the fire, guys.
I'm a rogue, I know that feeling all my life.
I'll get some more buffs before the boss here.
do the trash pull with the boss? No. Clearing everything?
No, it's just you need space in phase two so you can kind of spread out a bit more. It's just nice to have space. I guess once we progress more in the weeks, we won't bother.
One thing we could maybe check is if all the range basically just stand at the edge of his like designated hitbox. So basically to just see if he then one-shots us or if he actually needs to walk over still. Meaning that whether we have to run from him or not.
Yeah, exactly. The discussion we had last week, or on Sunday.
That's what I'm saying.
So, phase one, move away from the fire. Tanks need to be in top three threat all times, that's why Kieran tanks it so the others can catch up. The last 60 seconds, phase two, again, another 60 seconds, you're going to get fixated, one random person is. It can happen on pets too, which is kind of painful.
Probably do pet on passive during it, like no need to put your pet on.
Yeah. It's basically like Thaladred. Move away from, there's going to be like volcanoes on the floor, move away from them.
I just want to point out with those volcanoes, move them away immediately. Like,
yeah.
Like, if you're longer than 2 seconds, you're in one shot territory.
Does it matter if I take over on Fred?
It kind of does, like on Patchwork. Like, you're the best
you to soak their whole face.
Because yeah. You can easily dodge them. Like, you probably have the highest HP pool and highest dodge rate, so you're the best to soak hatefuls. So please try not to overtake.
Okay, but please, my threat leader is really scuffed, so please.
I'll call that out, it should be fine.
I need some guidance on that one.
Yeah. Kieran's obviously got Exorcism as well here, which makes it a bit easier. So. Alright.
Plus, like, on.
Oh, sorry.
Threat wipe after the gaze phase, so give tanks a moment to pick up again.
Yeah, back in phase one, yeah.
And. Just like Thaladred, he can be tanked by tanks in phase 2. So if you get it as a tank, the guys, you can just like take it, I guess. It's not too bad.
Oh, sorry, one more thing to say as well in phase 2. If you're more than 40 yards away from him, he'll charge and normally kill you. So try and stay in range, but out of range.
He won't kill you, but he will kill someone and then melee range after the charge, because it's like a future.
I see. Alright, Kieran, after you then. You put him on a mount up to run in now.
Yep.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'll empty the pull.
I have already, sorry.
No, that's fine. I'll empty the switch then.
How are you so far away, Huron?
You mounted.
Shangri's not in top 3.
Am I too far away? Are you okay?
No, now it's fine, but the beginning was.
Bit monker.
Okay, Shangri's in now. Not anymore, yeah, he's done. Okay. Maybe throw an MD shoot to Shangri if you can.
Okay, I'll do it. Careful, Marius, you're gonna probably take one.
Hero Assault if you can. Like, probably too late now anyway, but.
Yeah, it's way too late now.
Just wait till second phase, like second setting phase.
Yeah, Marius got clapped. Okay, kite phase, be ready to kite. Let's go into Aelia, let's go into Nord. Let's go into Shangri. Let's go into me.
Okay, the volcano's on the pathway as well.
Yeah, you
people
need to move
that.
Volcanoes fast. They do a lot of damage.
So Pinky in, yeah?
They also have a big range.
Yeah, mega range. Shangri on you.
Don't let him die.
Don't get hit so much.
Lorenzo, yeah, you're 40 yards away.
I couldn't be because I was DPSing with Shadow Bolt.
Alright, and back to tank phase again. I let them get a threat. Ah, we didn't learn a lesson about Curse of Doom. Alright, tanks are in top 3, it's fine.
I think a lot of us died to the volcanoes there. Just not quick enough moving from them. I definitely didn't move as quick as I could have done.
Blinked out and right into a flame patch.
That just sucks.
I walked into a volcano. Smile.
Into the actual...
Just in the rim of its radius, basically. Like, it's
right.
Bigger than that force, basically.
Alright, kite phase and turn. You ready? So you want to be in 40 yards of range.
Whoever's doom that is, you're probably going to get aggro.
Okay.
Okay, kite phase on Kieran.
That was weird. I saw me having aggro and Apatos died.
Yeah, kind of goes a bit strange.
Is he now? You need to be not more than 40 yards away from his center hitbox, not his round hitbox.
It's fine, it'll change, yeah. There we go.
Okay.
You know?
Like, not from the red circle, but from the center of him.
Okay.
Okay, you see again. Gary now. Yeah, you got tank phase in about 5 seconds, so I'm gonna kill it. Maybe you got Hellstone and stuff like that. Tank phase again. Yeah. Abacus didn't learn his lesson twice about Doom. Alright. It's probably going to be a wipe here. Yeah, just wipe up.
It's not how you Doom, it's whether you Doom alone or not.
So what is it we're doing completely differently from last time?
So a lot of us died that first
yeah,
time
I think
to the volcanoes. Like them volcanoes spawned 3 in a row right next to each other. And I know I could have moved quicker, but I'm assuming that's what happened to the others at the start as well.
I think there's actually like nearly, there's 8 people that died from the guys at the start. So we would have killed it now, probably, or around now. Didn't happen, but yeah, just be ready for it, I mean. Bear in mind, like, a third of the raid hasn't seen this part before, so that's why we're here.
Just remember, you can also move left and right, not up and down. Like, the volcanoes were all in the main path, and you can just move left and right. You don't have to stand there.
So you want to, and then there's also, you want to be stood 40 yards to his center, otherwise if you're further than 40 yards he'll charge you and then melee you. Or melee someone else. So
why is he walking so slowly?
Cause he's dummy thick.
He's a big man.
All the things to complain about him walking slow isn't one in my
I want to use my soulstone but he's literally like
he wants to rub it in that he killed us.
Like, that was the slowest reset ever.
Kieran, if you go in by mount, it's okay. I just need to know it before. That was...
a bit of a shock. Okay, fair enough.
So suddenly you were 40 yards away from me, out of range, getting damage.
It was scary.
How far can we go? This
I
didn't pull until I was really close, if I'm honest with you. I can
yeah, I'm not sure how close we can get to.
I don't know if we can rest a shaman. Kieran.
jumps in front of the boss.
Ah, rescue.
I guess I'm kicking this guy after his fake DC. Unless he told you otherwise, Nasa.
No. Was he in Discord and just left?
No, I think I was stuck.
If you clicked on this.
What's up, guys? Welcome to another subscriber text game.
I just say, you reckon it's even worth for Shang-Gi to try pick him up during phase 2, considering all the damage that's going out, healing the tank on top of that?
Not actively pick him up, no, but if he gets hit, like if he gets the gaze, just take it.
He can completely tank him.
No, every single fixate, you just need to re-get him, basically.
Yeah. It would probably help your DPS a lot if it would stand still, especially for casters. I mean, you can try it. That's probably, isn't that one of the reasons why we're here?
Just reload my gap.
Alright, so this time,
yes.
Well, MD, to be honest, the transition didn't seem too bad, besides the dooms, but the initial thing will lust and pull, and then we'll also, what was I saying? Lust and pull and stack MDs on the tank that's got the lowest threat. If you MD Kieran and pull Tilly, and I'll pick up whoever's not high enough. Yeah. And then just don't die to the volcano. That's it. If everyone mounts up, it's probably better. So mount up and then we can run in. I'll do a pull timer for 10, I guess. I should really check first, sorry.
Wanna swap groups a little bit around some, considering there's no longer a last shaman for Shang-Gi now?
Yeah. Go for it.
Just need the shaman in the group 2 then, don't you, for the tanks. He swaps out Marius or Hunter.
No, swap me out. Okay. Alright.
This is just...
Okay. Oh wait, sorry, Appy, you're okay? Wait.
Five.
Appy, yeah?
No, yeah, I am, but the mount does not work.
That's fine. Alright, Kieran, go in if you do.
Yep, go in now.
Just care on threat at the start, please. Heroisms if you've got it. Okay, threat looks really good. Alright, about 20 more seconds.
We've got got one Doom on the wrong timer again.
Just swap it then. Do affliction.
Swap out the Doom, whoever put the Doom up first.
Minus at 35 seconds.
One's just about to tick on the transition.
Abba?
It will work. I have Shattered, it's fine.
Okay.
It was a time.
Okay, kite now, so be in 40 yards. So I'm Kieran.
Mage
let him die.
Move from the blue fire, remember? Oh, sleeping here, one shot. Radari on you now. Oh, Abba on you now.
You were so far behind him.
Radari,
the boss is so big, it's 40, more than 40 yards and then on the boss.
Care the volcano near him, care. Like,
under his feet, yeah.
Okay. Man, that's so TG. Fucking hard.
TG? Oh, come on, rest for it. Oh, you got him up, nice. Just give Radari some buffs, please.
Again, there's a volcano nearby, careful.
5 seconds now.
Just,
Okay, tank phase, here we go. All tanks are in the top, it's good.
After some consideration, I've decided to give in on the Doom issue.
Careful consideration.
We should be able to kill him now, let's just keep going. Twenty seconds for the next phase.
Shangri, is it now? Careful.
Okay, kite phase. So be ready, be in 40 yards. Auron, for you. TG, for you. Back to Auron. Helio now. Kieran, Xylo.
Okay, then under him again.
On me.
It's you.
Probably gonna feign it here in a sec. I'm just gonna die. Plus, you know, this should be fine. Okay. One's ducky. I'll tell you now. And tank phase, try to kill it. Okay, well that wasn't awful. There's definitely some things to improve there. It was obviously better than the last attempt. I think it's just gotta be careful, like super careful on the spins when it the threat seems kind of scuffed, like I don't know. Like, if, for a second there it was on, it went Auron, TG, Auron, TG, or Auron.
Yeah,
and
well, the second time it went to me, I just got meleeed and killed. So
yeah.
Maybe it was on me after all. Either I over aggroed or Auron over aggroed or something like that.
I was throwing the focus phase, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
But, I mean, in reality as well, DPS doesn't matter pretty much at all during the kite phase. Like, it's just surviving and then you kill during the Zerg phase. Obviously it matters, right? But not as much as it does as staying alive for the next phase.
I'm just gonna say I couldn't find a good position to actually be at him. Because being inside of the red circle on him means that you die.
Yeah,
being outside of it means that you get thrown away. Being exactly on the edge, maybe, is good enough, but then you have to instantly start running.
You've got like a 10-yard gap from the edge of his red circle. Just stay in that.
Nope.
It's pretty easy.
I got thrown away, standing just outside the red circle.
I think that's slightly the same as Saladrid as well, where sometimes you do just get bopped back for no reason. Like, I got bopped back, but then I was finally I could run it around, and I was definitely at like 10-15 yards outside the red circle, so...
Yeah, follow dread tends to do that as well. Like, even if you're in correct range.
Yeah.
Like, the one thing that is, that really isn't good is, like, if you're, like, directly behind the way that is kiting, sort of, like, in a 90-degree angle. He seems to just make one step further, like, even after the fixate drops, then he's just one step further away from you. Like, if you're doing it exactly, like, at the edge of what's possible, then you will be out of range once you made the final step.
Okay. No longer you're going to banish circle here.
Okay.
Everything else we're just going to kind of nuke down. Heartseekers do like, well, they're hunters. And then bone slicers like a rogue. Kill
Centurions face away from the raids.
Cool. And then, yeah, we're going to bring it back to pretty much where we are now. So, probably like Kirim. That's fine. I'll trap here.
I gave us back Pinky, by the way.
There's a guy. There's a guy.
A Heartseeker. Loose. Yeah, you got it, good. We'll finish off the school.
Do you need to decurse as well?
Yeah, decurse if you can, mages. Just kind of bring this shit a bit closer. Yeah, excellent.
Mimic, Dremel, Sonata, Kieran, Zenzia. You can put debuffs, negative debuffs showing on standard Blizzard Raid Flames. So
daily nab. I thought that is standard.
Yeah, it's standard Blizzard Raid Flames shows it.
We got the Rain of Chaos here, it really does a lot of damage. Same again on the left side. Let's go quick that mana.
Considering what just happened, we might just wait a little bit for Kieran to pick up the Satus.
Rudder?
Yeah, should be.
See, that is a fucking print screen and a half.
That's gotten into the leverage folder.
Yeah, this is me actually.
You might just want to banish the Heartseeker as well, since he just stays in range.
Yeah.
Do you agree?
Banish that circle if you want to pick him up.
Yeah, for the patrol here, if we get the patrol, it's pretty bad. Okay, it's fine.
We can ignore the guys on the stairs and just go right, can't we?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Just gotta be careful with the pack on the left to us, with the wolf.
Yep.
The wolf has a huge accuracy race, and you want to pull it all the way back into here, where we are right now.
Literally don't go past where we are now. Come back here.
And then just
you can probably pull out now while we wait for the patrol.
Just let the two solo tanks pick the battle lords and here in the rest, and just focus everything before the battle lords, like primal lists, mystics, all that stuff.
Patrol's coming now.
Care bolt up, by the way. Don't ask.
Oh, easy scrolls.
I want to grab the patrol rather than.
There's two patrols on each side.
Patrol two, but... I guess.
Are we getting this patrol?
Yeah, get it. Why not? Oh, sorry, I just read a blind on this one. Just, Tess, can you banish one of these bone slices? I assume you can. Just do a small one. Yeah, you can. Okay, cool.
Immune. Yeah, with this one, just starts hitting heavy after like 4 ticks. Then just hit the Shadow Fiends.
I'm sorry, I've got to wait so I can press that until Kieran tells me to.
Thank you. No one goes, that's very respectful. Well, this could be trouble. Okay, we're fine. It.
Second pack, plus.
Now we can leave it, we can just get the pack instead.
I think the Stormcall also the totem switch one. Have to be cool. There's one that summons like a little elemental boy.
We can kill these here, but probably in reality we'd take them back, but it's fine. The OED on the seeds should be okay then.
There's a Stalker in as well, care.
Kill the Cyclone totem, please. Yeah. Yeah. That's nice, Tom. Just keep that shit out of the way.
Take crit off a fucking Storm Fury thing. Oh man, this game.
Just wait for the patrol now.
Patrol now, yep.
No info on Bitcoin set.
Therefore, you can outrange this.
Of epic gems from the trash.
I was literally going to say the same thing, yeah. It's dropped nicely.
How are tanks taking these right now? Like who is on who? Because I would argue that have the two big dudes, Rodari and Shangri respectively. And all the other thing on Kieran.
Yeah.
5, 4. You wanna probably lost pull them back two, because all of these haters are ranged.
Yeah, we'll do. No one do anything then.
Banish both of the defilers, please. Circle and diamond. Banish them. Thank you.
Well, I got silenced.
That's not diamond.
Yeah, I got silenced.
Bone slice with the back on. Oh, they can be stunned. Or just feared.
Yeah, fucking kid.
Feared. That's exactly what I found as well when I tanked this on whenever it was.
Which mobs is it silencing?
The big ones, yeah.
Yeah, the big boys. We can rebanish diamond, by the way, please. Or one of them at least.
Yeah, pulling them back definitely isn't a good idea.
Careful with going into the doorway because the packs on each side have the wolf, so chances are you will pull both of them. Best idea for that room is probably to have a hunter just MD pull either side, and then go as normally.
You mean MD Alibus pull?
Yeah, something like this. So, happened right now. Just yeah. So now we get both sides. That's what I mean. Like, just.
I'm sure to control it.
Don't AoE. Let Kieran try and grab everything and focus down the walls first and totems before anything.
Wolves can be tracked.
Yeah. Maybe actually.
I'm already asking because I don't have Purge on my bars on PTR, so I can't do it.
And then the Primalist, because he does the annoying wing clip, which is like a cleave, so it's multiple targets.
You turn away or not?
Turn what away?
The Primalist, so it doesn't cleave.
Maybe, but
the Primal is short range hunters. The better Lord's sleeve, though.
That really was taking out for most of the fight and it didn't do anything.
Yeah, it does the sweeping, I guess, which is annoying for melee. Because the problem is
we can
it's
get
more important
here,
to turn the cleave around than the sweeper. Not the cleave. Yeah, you know what I mean.
That's fine. Let's wait on. Just wait on start here.
What was it I was tanking for the entire fight?
The hunter guy.
The one that
didn't take any damage at all this time, this fight.
Yeah. I guess they shoot for pretty little damage, so.
No, as in, I didn't take any damage.
Good take, by the way.
We get kings for the Yungthul Maris.
And then just remember here.
Right pack, same again.
The Primal is just go with standard NPC hunter logic of netting all the melees and then moving into a ranged position. So that's not avoidable.
So I guess it makes sense if Rodari and Shangri are on Triangle and Diamond, then yeah. And face them away, because I think it's easier for you to face things away than for Kieran, who tanks multiple.
Yeah, sure, I'll do damage then.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And then before we do the next pull, we prepare for the boss fight. On the chain. That's...
Yeah, so let's just wait. I mean, once we kill this, let's just get full mana buffs, everything, and then wait. Alright. So it's a Giga easy fight. We're not going to do the... Which one is it? Battle Lord? That's it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so... the Battle Lord we're going to pull out. Rodari, I guess you can do that and just take it away slowly. Everyone else we kill. We then start the encounter. Again, not that you can start that or I can, it's up to you. The Battle Lord, Rodari, you're going to place it where you did it again. In the dead center, you're going to line up all your seeds on it. Blast, 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 and we're going to kill all the channelers that are now channeling the shade. Once all the channelers are dead, he then basically walks down and starts killing a Karma, and you have to kill him before he kills a Karma. It's like a DPS race, but it's giga easy. Just be ready on the sides, Kieran and Shangri, to pick up the groups of ads or the waves of ads. I had a bit of trouble picking them up, but maybe it's just because I'm a retard, that like they seem to hone to one target and want to run there first before they attack you, even if you attack them. But then some did and some didn't, so maybe it's just me.
I guess what's helpful... Sorry,
where did the spawning from, Tom?
Literally left and right here, the
doors.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
So, is that what you're saying?
Something that might help with the picking up is if hunters can just do frost traps at each site. That might help.
Sure. Mm-hmm. I'll do that if you want.
Sure. Just be aware for like the rain of fire. Like, this is the main thing that hurts people during this. The elementals that do the rain of fire. This hit for a lot, so.
So, you want frost traps start of phase 2? Do you want them right in the doorway?
Just do them once you start the encounter, basically, ideally.
Yeah. So it's like the north side of the doorway.
Okay. Before you despawn before we phase, but we'll see.
Yeah.
Start of the encounter, I mean, not this encounter, but like when we start the actual.
The bus, yeah.
Yeah, I know. Okay, yeah, no, I understand. Sorry. No, I understand.
Alright. Let's go then. Just don't damage Diamond here, kill the Skull and Cross. And then Radari just pull it out. Alright, cool. Let's go. Save Bloodlust for. Phase 2. LOS this stuff as well, please.
Yep, actually, cool. This time we saved Bloodlust for Phase 2 last time. Maybe this time try and use it.
Oh, sorry, yeah, the challenge.
The
yeah,
right.
Yeah. Bring this. Oh, it's fine. Just kill it there. Just move Diamond away. Yeah.
Bring excellent. Diamond into a Karma already, I guess. Like into the shade.
Yeah.
Then somebody can start the encounter already as well.
Okay, literally nobody should be hitting. Diamond here, I'm gonna start the encounter now. Just solo pump the channelers. Okay, going in 3, 2, 1 now. Oh, that was a lot quicker than I expected. They're not active yet, so wait, so wait, so wait, so wait, so wait. And go, heroisms, let's go. All cooldowns.
Taking all five, that's good.
Smadson in the middle. Tanks. East.
Help.
Okay, so he's moving now. I'll push the ads, just kill him.
Finish off these ads. Be ready to kill the boss. Everyone needs to be around the boss now, ready to kill it. and don't let them pump shit into them yet. Bring the rest of Cleave under. Okay, here we go. Big Zug on the boss now. Bring everything else just Cleave under, yeah, exactly.
I guess it doesn't matter where you hero, like you have remaining time.
Yeah, but I would hero in this phase because Akama is barely stronger than his shade, so.
Yeah.
Like, if we lose people to some unlucky RNG or something early on, this might. Like, Akama might actually die.
He did drop a bit low there, yeah.
Yeah.
33% something. So. Pretty much worth racing as well, because I feel like.
Yeah, probably, but then you heal less people.
I wouldn't even hero any of the phases.
So just for those who don't hear, the Ashton guys become now friendly after the Akama RP is done. You can talk to the quartermaster back there.
Yeah, don't move up before they are friendly.
Yeah. Also be careful, there's still some stalkers around the stairs that can backstab you. Like friends.
Oh, that's just sad.
Oh.
Didn't think you had any.
Exactly, now you know why.
It's because he's being backstabbed by you.
This is basically where you buy the reputation crafted shadow resistance gear, as well as the class trinkets you get with Exalted, most of which are garbage. As is usual.
Trash.
I think the Hunter one's actually not horrible, just not good.
Which way are we going? Right side?
Terran, right. Less so forward. Great. Here.
Okay.
Also, you can repair upstairs. And the guy at the entrance teleports you up to here now, where the star is. So if we wipe on Terran, for example, you can talk to the guy, teleport you here. You have less path to walk. Happy times.
Like the most of the like the extra quest chains we get with the extra Ashtang web, like, end with handing into Akama. Like, this would be the last step then. Like, we should probably be able to see if we need more rep before we kill Akama.
Okay.
We can move up here, so there's a patrol that comes down, just take care. The rest of this. I think this was just a lot of tank and spank. The champions do a lot of damage, but...
Like, for almost everything, like... The baseline in this raid seems to be phase everything away from the raid. Yeah. Like, it's here, same here as well, basically. Just phase it away and be happy. The wolves are not as bad as the ones in Shadow Halls in terms of damage, so... Can be semi-ignored. Just wait for the patrol, I guess, to go away, even though it wouldn't matter too much, probably, but...
Kieran is AFK right now, I think.
Oh, I see.
They just needed a few minutes, yeah. A few seconds, sorry. Good time to rebuff foods and stuff like that.
Can we duo tank a pack of four mobs? Or?
Probably. If you want to. I don't care really.
Okay.
Just gonna mock up some things anyway.
Bring it back, yeah. Perfect. Just remember that Shangri Radari don't have their facilities that. Doing this.
Stuff is wrong with my facilities, so I'll have you know. Thank you.
There's a spinning axe in the Red, careful. Like, the positioning is awkward because now you either have to move into the patrol or.
Downstairs, yeah.
Shield wall used, Monka.
Get by inside.
Okay. Drastic measures.
Help, 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 help.
Those whirlwind blades, do they do mana drain?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, pretty sure.
Because all of a sudden I hit zero mana.
It's like, even if they don't hurt much, you probably still want to move away from them as a mana user.
We might want to like have melee's focus on the weavers and casters on the champions, because the weavers absorb magical hits and then shoot it back.
Okay, to know. So you just go in the Haunt Masters first. I think the dogs do charge random people, but not for much hurt. Here's the blood mages. Let's take the back on the left side. Be careful with right side. These blood mages, if you can take them, Shangri Rodari, and face them away from the right as well. Whilst they do some weird blood volley AoE stuff, which hurts. Rest is just do nothing. So.
I'll go first.
Blood Bowl is an AoV around the target that gets hit, but it doesn't hit for a lot, like 2 to 3k.
Don't say Blood Boil, too much PTSD.
I can't wait for your brief explanation on Blood Boil.
Hello. I'm actually gonna do the Abacus strat this time, I think.
I'm gonna record it again.
No. Let's shut up, please.
No!
On the...
There's a pack just to the right, if you fold it.
Maybe the sixth group is the pet group, is that right?
See, so now everybody ate a blood boil.
Where is Hina's interrupter?
No, you can't. Try
the casters, I'm rumoring. Only does like 900 damage, right? Yeah, that's not too impactful.
Some reavers face.
Gonna pull them back down. Shall I pull them to the stairs again, or we're gonna tank?
Pull them where we are right now. Should be fine.
Make a skull, please.
Even making cross and triangle. Actual high quality raid leading. Fuck you.
Sorry, I'm just finishing up my food. I must say, I'm going to touch wood before I say it. The Warlocks have been very well behaved today, besides Abacus on the Inferno.
It's just a bad time, to be honest.
Okay, say that again, I dare you.
What do you reckon, Warlocks?
Well, like, it's been bad for me, personally.
Abacus is still in my good books.
I bopped you as well quite a couple times now.
Yeah.
Ah.
like I said last week, you can skip Peroni this week. Actually, we did, didn't we?
Yeah, just left.
So just suck left again. All the little guys do not much. Also don't have much AP. The big guy is like the Marshal in Tempest Keep with the massive whirlwind. But this one actually follows the tank. So if you as a tank get it, like if he's in you as a tank and he whirlwinds, you can actually move him away, basically. So he's like a Beyblade for those that are not Zoomers.
Or a spinning top for Zoomers, I guess.
What's a Zoomer?
We're taking all this with
this. Yeah, you can take the Hunter.
Yeah, yeah. So obviously go easy a little bit on the threat this time.
So there's the Warband.
Oh, the Hounds charge.
Yeah, but like I said, they don't hit for much, I think.
No.
Yeah, they war charge just.
What?
I don't know, you see the death recap. How much did they hit you for?
Yeah, charge into melee swing for 10k.
Charge melee future, yeah.
That's the intentional mechanics.
Only 1.4k.
See, so if it's not the, if you don't get the extra, we'll be fine. Otherwise, it's just the LR experience.
Yeah, the, Well, that's exactly how you do it, Shankar's good.
Dispel the right.
I'm dead.
Thank you.
I died trying to Master Spell. It charged me and killed me.
But Master Spell did work now? Because I feel like all the right just suddenly was free.
You died trying to masturbate.
Spell.
I think Deadwing has a very high drop chance.
Yeah, I've seen a few.
I think
it's
a
lot of people need it.
Definitely a caster.
Yeah, it is a caster ring. By casters, I mean healer.
No, DPS, like Warlock. Mm. Warlock this.
I need two of those rings, thank you.
I'm just gonna fuck up a grunt here.
Do you know that there's a caster version of the same, right?
Yeah, we need both of them.
It's good to have until you get that one, though, right?
That is true.
You can use both.
Yeah, but you can also just use double trash caster rings.
I mean, can you not just use the DPS one twice?
You can, yeah. We've got to use that one to before we get that one.
What? Mm-hmm.
Well, that means that otherwise you get the healer one, which is bad.
That is the healer one.
Yeah, but we need
that
before you. We need that before you, and then before we get the DPS one.
Why?
Because it's important.
It's also important that I have two of those.
No, you don't need them.
Yeah, I do.
No, I've got to your list, you don't need it.
One more.
I could have rolled on your DPS loot then.
No, you're not on the loot council, it doesn't matter.
Did you also fall as a baby?
I think my mum dropped me on the head from the top of a cherry picker.
How many times? Like, that makes even less sense, the whole group 6 thing.
Obviously, Max will be better in actual raids than right now.
It's not gonna come far, obviously.
It's not. Huh? What?
Never mind.
Did I get trash talked? Or...
Yeah,
a little bit. Sorry.
Kieran.
What?
Sassy. I'm calling you Mimric.
This is the experience of how it feels to play against a Frost Mage in PvP as a melee. With the 30-second route.
Just tell your healer to dispel you.
Just play Rat Paladin.
Coming from the rogue with every fucking cooldown under the sun that just can't be fucking killed.
We just run here now, we pick up the grunts that run towards us.
Yeah.
Just fucking. Okay. And then the big skeleton. He swaps targets basically and does a massive cliff, so you have to have two tanks on it. So Radari and Chengri just pee on it, and Radari, Kieran just tank all the blood mages around him.
The idea is that you kill all the blood mages first and then look at the other one afterwards. There's a big threat lead. Let's go.
skull, but obviously just kill the blood mages first and stuff, then worry about the rest later.
Like how you say that we should kill the blood mages first, but then put skull on the skeleton.
Skull means danger.
Yeah,
doesn't it?
Hmm?
Skull means danger. Stay away from it.
Any ear users? He literally just said, "I put a skull on the skeleton, but kill the blood mages first."
Yeah, that's what I commented on. So,
but he said
that
for you.
For skull means kill.
No, skull is danger, we stay away.
Skull are for me, like, all the shit is tank marks for me. Like, if you have, example, skull, Shangri, then I put something on this.
But I know this is a hard concept, Narset, but not everyone is like you. I know this is...
This is why you use your ears, to listen to what Narset says.
Yeah, that's exactly what I did, and said that don't put skull on it then.
What if I have a mind ignore?
Rude.
Asking for a friend.
Then I end up with a situation like an SST where I have four different assignments for trash and I can't be bothered to swap around.
You've got to be a fucking astrophysicist to fucking work in this fucking raid, don't you?
You just don't have to be a mouth.
Yeah, I don't know.
I guess.
I'll stand across how you do score.
Since we are here to try out shit, Kieran, do you want to try and main tank this?
Oh, yeah. If you want to be my threat, feels really good against tonight. Most of it's just demons and undead in it, so.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, this one is undead, I don't know if it's any different for you.
Yeah, no, it'll be fine, yeah. Thanks, that's good.
Just bear in mind, this guy hits very hard, like very hard, so.
Might...
Oh. Yeah, like two shot Radari.
Yeah, but not the second time because we had all our abilities ready.
Yeah, so I guess if you put on some extra... I don't know how good your capabilities as a prot paladin are for this, but... You don't have to, of course. I'm not trying to force you into anything, just...
Do not click off the debuff, please. From the buff of the ghost. Just wanna say this before we start.
So... Okay, so this boss is basically the minigame boss fight which Oren linked a while ago. it comes on your pet bar, so you get a debuff, it lasts like 60 seconds. When it's about 15 seconds, just move to like as far back in the room as possible.
To the corner, basically, like...
Yeah, so like one of these here. And then you want to do, create a home wrong, 4... 5, and then 3 tab, 3 tab, 3 tab, 3 tab, right?
Yep.
So...
No, wait, 5, 4,
5,
3, 4, 3, 3.
Yeah.
5, 4, 3, 3, 3, 3, okay.
And then 5, 4 again, when it's up.
But if I've moved my buttons, I've got to press 4, 3, 2, 2, 2. Or 4-3.
Oh, no.
2 caps.
No, no numbers, no more numbers.
4-2-3.
Just don't listen to Momo, basically.
Yeah. So and then you want to do 3 tabs, so you want to make sure that you've got all of the slowing shit on all of them. We saw it last time where we had like, well, I don't think there was, only Nord did it successfully, and actually it wasn't too bad having like one or two come through. Obviously if you fuck up the ghost, you can still kill them when they're underneath the boss, so just be ready.
Just don't panic, just take your time with it. I mean,
yeah,
if,
honestly.
If you fuck up, it doesn't matter, this is learning.
Yeah, exactly.
Another thing, like if you're running back as like the second person, do not run back through the skeletons, just run to the other corner.
Yeah.
Like you don't want to get killed halfway.
Yeah, I
another
say
thing,
we're boss tanking.
Another thing that Tam mentioned after our wipe last time is that unlike the mini game, you don't have infinite range here. You actually have to move with the guys.
Yeah. True. Also bear in mind that on the pet bar, the default is control 3 rather than 3. So you're going to do control 3 tab, or whatever your keybinds are. Radar, you're going to basically turn him where he is now.
Kieran,
you're going to turn him through.
Don't turn
180 degrees. You know?
Why do you want to turn him?
No, no, Kieran stands exactly in the middle of the circle. The rest of the raid stands behind where Terran is standing now.
Yeah,
we as far as possible from the skeletons. So yeah.
Is Terran facing where he is now? Or is
you just take him exactly the way he is and everybody else moves behind.
No, Reno, you're fucking toxic, man.
Retard.
5, 4.
MDs will hear him. I'll MD the pool. 2, oh, you got it. It's fine. I won't be at the back of the room. And I pretty much gas from the start, assuming that Kieran's stats good.
You'll do some heroes and shenanigans if you can.
It's the first one's on you, Narina.
Oh no.
Excited to watch you fuck it up.
See how it goes.
What UI areas are you gonna have?
Alien next. Alright, Marina, you be ready? 5, 4, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, yeah.
9, 4, 5.
5, 4?
Yeah, 5, 4. Five, oh, fuck. I swear to God, my actual worst.
Just let us know if you're doing bad, Marina.
I can see them slowed, it's looking good.
Oh no, I have it as well.
You gonna do 5-4 or 4-5?
3-7-2. Well done though, Rina, excellent job. Alien next. Let's see another excellent job, please.
Next, please!
It's because he was in the sanctum.
First time in 15 years.
Earlier.
Nah, fuck this, I'm gonna go around here and just die in a bit.
Try to click off the buff. Ghost buff.
Yes, did that work?
And I died. Oh man, so that felt good after that fucking comment.
Not that guy.
I'm on the way, yeah.
Okay. Alien did it well as well.
Of course he did.
Well done now.
Fucking thing, man.
Okay.
I think I got help, but yeah.
Nice, Marius.
You would have done it perfectly anyway. Well said.
You I can't have the right to. Now, right? Control 7? Just... No?
What?
Yeah, I can shield you. I gave you a shield. I don't know what it does, but.
Oh, I thought you wanted me to do something. I'm like, what?
You don't care and shield! That was really, really clean, guys. Good job.
Protect the friendly target for the barrier, absorbing 11 to 12k shadow damage. Okay.
Well done. That was really, really nice. Well done.
I probably don't put that on the tank. Like, maybe the target that has the increased shadow damage taking debuff. Also, just for anybody curious, if you make him untarget you, it will just choose another victim for the Mark of Death, like vanishing it. I just tried that. It just chose Alia instead, like immediately after. So if you don't wanna do it, you can give somebody else the responsibility.
Can you click off the buff, Marius? I even got 2 seconds. Yeah, can you click it off?
But if you keep it for 50 seconds and then make it come off, do they get one for 60 seconds?
No, like the direct like target loss abilities, feign, vanish, make him like recast immediately, and you like he will stop the cast on you. The question now is what immunities do. Like that, obviously, I wasn't targeted again, so I couldn't test that.
My action bar is now different.
Okay. Not, sorry, genuinely you did 5, 4, 3, 3, 3, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That was really, really nice how he did that. Hold on, everyone. Cool. Next to Reliquary.
I need to figure out what I have to do to my action bar, because...
Can you just reload?
No, I tried, but I think I did some keybind where I go to the next page. But I don't know which it was, so...
Like control mouse wheel up and down?
No, that's shift, a rock strike.
Shift. Or shift scroll.
No, I stopped that.
Anyway.
Okay, I got that to work now. Can I get a summon maybe? I'm lazy.
I suppose. Is anyone in this group with the same character that they did on last week? What reps have you got?
Yeah, quite a lot of Winter Honored. Reputation 2.894.
Okay, that's really good then.
That is really good, Jesus. How many bosses did you do last week?
Killed Shiraz, so 7 out of 9.
Is anybody summoning or?
We've just
arrived. Fucking hell.
So fucking pussy. What's your fucking name?
Got the hammer down.
What? What's your name? Frisbee.
Fucking idiot.
I like Frisbee. Thank you.
No problem, Fizzbees.
Do you want to go Reliquary again or Blood Boil? I don't want to go Blood Boil.
I want to DC before Blood Boil.
Yeah,
so
can you
get Reliquary first?
Before Blood Boil?
Yeah.
Cool, thank you.
Let's move in.
Thanks, brother. this pack. Wolf, kill wolf first.
We get double wolf.
And then
sorry,
disarm the blade furies.
Exactly, blade furies next.
Walk out of dead wolves.
Yeah, they rot underneath, so be careful.
Don't move too close to the big
guy. Yeah, come back a little bit.
There's a big guy in the raid.
That's a small guy compared to the big guy.
And yeah, I took aggro from
No, they reset.
They're good now.
Oh, they beat.
Yeah, be careful not to cross. That'd
be shit. I ain't touching shit, I'm letting other people die for me.
I guess once the Blade Fury is dead, like now all are dead, you can see it happily now. Because the rest doesn't
do
much.
It
really
doesn't do much damage now because there's no targets up. It's fun when there's 8 targets up, who's not shield walled.
Did I see a flying shield through the wall then? Through the raid? Am I tripping?
No, that's happened.
Okay. I don't know what it did. There, it's there again.
It stunned us, I think.
Ah.
We're getting surprisingly many hearts this time, as you feel like.
Yeah, way more. I don't know if maybe there's been some changes. There's nothing to
it's more or less the same. I needed most of them last time as well, and it's pretty much the same.
Greedy motherfucker.
Yeah. Needy motherfucker, actually.
Funny.
Unlucky Zyla. Are we stuck on this, or?
Can we get some more Shadow Embrace
stacks.
So I think this is like the brute mini game, so we will fail it anyways. Yeah.
Wait,
yeah.
So there is a charge?
There's a charge, apparently.
Okay, so let's stack up then. Okay, we got the other one too.
Is he charging the furthest, don't we?
I think
maybe if you tread up.
Gino was further out than me.
I was.
Okay.
I don't think there's a minimum target range either. Like, even if you're all in melee, it will charge.
Really?
Then probably it won't melee anyone if after the charge.
It's comment that you're supposed to stack for does like no damage at all. That's.
One more pack before the event. I guess same with the dogs, is it? Oh no, sorry, they're casters this time.
Line of sight these bugs.
Sorry for swapping the things, but
it's fine then.
You have cataracts, my concentration with no one arrow, any of these and stuff.
Alright, so let's not go through the gauntlet yet. Let's explain the boss first quickly. So, in essence, phase one, you get drained mana. You have to kill the boss before it completely drains.
No, that's phase two, mate. No.
Phase one, the boss has zero armor. Everybody else has zero armor. The tank is decided by proximity, not by threat. The tanks will need to cycle in and out to get new power board shields, and he will periodically enrage. Like in our last attempt, this was only happened once, where some tank with defensive CDs needs to tank it. I will try to blade to evasion this time, like soak the entire thing with.
I think you deceived.
He did, yeah. I think so.
Anyway, yeah, so. You do the tank swaps, basically.
Yeah, so you send the closest to the center.
So we just need a tank order now. So who's going first?
I think Kieran, like, Propolitan first is a good call. Then once your shield runs off, or you go like to, let's say, 60%, Shangri will go in and get a shield as well.
Like, as a pack priest bubble.
I fucking hate this game. I fucking hate this so much.
Okay, welcome back. Do you want to take over again, or should I do it?
No, carry on as you are. So Kieran's in for first shield and 60%. Then Shangri's going in for with second shield till 60%.
Yeah.
What's that?
Basically, you rotate and that's it. He does dispel the thing, the mana drain as soon as you can.
And Radari's going to take the last 25%, is it? When he's at 25% health?
No, he will invade periodically. This is not tied to his health bar at all, so. I will try and evasion it.
How long is the debuff when you get when you get shielded, by the way?
15 seconds.
So you could even do it, like, get shield, once shield is run out, call out, then tank swap, next tank gets shield, etc. Would this work?
Yes,
or is this too regular?
No, I think it would.
I guess if all tanks do this then, since they're vocal anyway, and do a Kieran, Shangri, Rodari rotation, this would probably be good as well.
Hunters, the shot that reduces targeted chance release as well in phase 1.
And so no Curse of Wreck too.
I can do it to this one.
Okay.
Since it's zero armor anyway, no need for recklessness as well.
Yeah. Phase
and
two
all,
is
all, all healers DPS away during this phase because you can't heal anybody. And the intermediary phase, you're just getting to full mana in HP anyway.
Can you earth shield?
It doesn't heal, but yeah, you can.
Okay, so you probably want to swap the earth shield target as well then between the tanks or.
No, it doesn't do anything. Like like there's an earth shield on you, and it will do like the spell casting thingy. But
right, let's
you
get,
don't
let's
get any
on,
healing.
Just keep on task. Keep on task
a bit now. So should we just go through? I think everyone. The only thing to watch out about phase three is the seed stuff. Phase two just fight for threat doesn't really matter.
And mages are gonna grab his shield because it's a good DPS boost for them.
No,
actually,
no,
sorry, Radar, you're gonna take.
Just purge it off as soon as possible. Like. No, if you don't want the shock blast to go through, like you can't interrupt it while the shield is up, and if the mage is too slow, if the mage is on GCD, it's not good.
Yeah, I agree. Let's go, Kieran, and then wait at the top of the ramp, please. Literally, just run through this. Like, grab the stuff, but just run through it. On the right side, mate. On the right side. Kill the little blobs that do the anger. Just keep walking, keep walking, keep walking. Radar, you're tanking phase 2. Phase 3 doesn't really matter. Just whoever gets it.
We've lost someone already.
Who?
Oh, Alpha.
Stay here. Everybody stay here so we can mess him.
Oh no, we'll have to stay in the Mirik, if you just come over, it's fine. Or Shangri do, actually, Shangri do. Right, get it and then move. Please don't go any further down than I am here. You want to be stood on top of me. No further down, stop, okay. Quick mana drink. Come down more and suck up those totems, please. Slay Pinky, grab the totems. Yeah, cool. Alright. Let's go.
Pain and suffering are all that await you.
Remember, it's the person that stands closest underneath the boss. So, melee, don't be too close in.
When do you want this to happen?
Let's do it phase...
Phase 3? Yeah, phase 2 is spell pushback.
Oh yeah, Pally's consecrate order for phase 2 as well. Not now, in phase 2. Hey, someone else needs to take it over from Kieran? Stand closer. Just play Radar's got it. It can be a bit weird. Rage is coming now.
Shangri. If you
move,
move
out a bit.
And then Shangri's in after the evasion finishes. Okay.
The evasion didn't finish, but sure.
Gotta kill it now.
No, we're not gonna. We need a fresh shield on Kieran.
And what you made me do.
Just wipe it up. Go again.
Yeah.
So.
Shangri went in 4 seconds too early, like the invasion was still going and my evasion was still up.
I don't wanna go back.
I was transitioning now. Just die as quickly as you can.
I think we can swap earlier as well. So, you, I think with the first swap and the second swap, or the first swap definitely. I know it's kind of funky, just getting used to it, isn't it?
Yeah, like the person that takes over moves first, and then the person that currently has it moves out, basically. Yeah. So it will immediately swap. Like, if the person that has it moves first, then the boss will just move with the person.
Thing is, if the debuff on you is 15 seconds, then you could technically tank swap every 5 seconds, no?
Yeah, that's what I expect. That's what I thought we were going to do then. So sort of in 5, or you... 5 or 6 seconds, then out, then next one in. 5 or 6 seconds.
We can res here. Cal has a DI. Just literally, Cal, just stay as close to the wall as you can. And then probably Shangri Alia will have to run.
Can I bubble that debuff, by the way?
Like, the no healing taken, or?
Yeah, the no healing.
Nah, that's a core mechanic of like every single phase. You can't bubble it.
Rocket. Can you bubble it and stand in it, though?
No, he will hit somebody else.
Okay. Oh, he pulled the boss anyway. It's fine. Yeah, just do the call again.
Unfortunately, for this, wipe it up. Go again.
I will quickly half stone to equip the PvP gloves. We might also want to do like the interrupt assignment.
Yeah. So I feel like we spent a lot of time talking about phase one, but didn't really cover the rest. But not too much anyway. So really, as a tank, if you see your shield go out, like run out, just announce it and have the next tank move in, and give him a shield.
Can you hear my mic? But can you hear me, Billy?
We can hear you.
I think I was gone before, because like I was trying to say there was a whole lot of talk in phase one, so like nobody could call. Tank swaps out.
You have a. Oh, good. It's just. Guess that. I don't feel there's much chance anyway, so you should probably have full stage for yourselves, really. Yeah. Can't think of anything that would need callouts besides the enrage, I guess, where Tam would then move in, of course. So.
Yeah, my mic mustn't be working the last time because I tried to mention some, but yeah.
Like you also have like zero defense and zero armor due to the debuff, so literally like any person is like a clothy takes as much hits without like if you don't count the avoidance. Like your avoidance is the only mitigation you have apart from active abilities in this fight. Yes, it just. I mean, kinda, I guess. It's a little bit. They shouldn't count the ceiling, right? So. But I don't think they will really be needed. Like, sorry. Go on.
Look at the guy, sorry. Just happy for 25 minutes.
Yay! Good kind.
Oh, that's me. What the fuck?
Bad kind. Nice. That's bad kind, not bald kind.
I know, I have bad kind as well.
Really?
On Navigat Keep, port side, yeah. This is how I got the heart, the rend for Gukant. I made a warrior.
You have nightmare suits with you, Radari?
Of course, always.
Good man. Shangri, do you have any? Okay, good chat. Shangri.
Do I have any what?
Nightmare seeds.
Can you use them in Bearfall?
Nightmare seed? No.
Okay. summon bad kind and then we can go.
Just waiting for him to be in Black Temple. And I'll do it. Can also summon him on the other end.
Or try it without, I guess. But
yeah, we're wasting time with it now. Alright, let's go there. Queuing up at the front.
Yep.
Let's just run through. Try and yeah. Is everyone here? Tyler?
One person moving, yeah.
Do a couple of stops so we don't get people killed. It's rough.
Oh, Maris is DC'd, fuck my life. Oh, no, he's not. Alright,
here we go. So, buff, groups 1 and 2 are like on the first interrupt that goes out, and group 3 and above are on the second. Unless you already wrote something and then they see it again.
No. Sounds good to me.
Pick up totems, guys. Grandpa, pick up totems. Hey, get on the ramp. Gotta be pretty much by the bone tonight. Right, finish this shot off, we're gonna have 10 seconds and then we'll go.
Don't forget, shot Viper, I think it was.
Yeah. It's Scorpion, yeah.
Isn't it? Last...
It is Viper is the mana one, right?
Correct.
Yeah, just the avoidance one, please.
Yeah, Scorpion.
Yeah. Alright, let's go.
Okay, let's go.
So this is perfect. So Kieran has a shield on him like this, and then he doesn't have the cooldown as well, so he's got plenty of time.
We have one
ad. Let's kill it in the back quickly. Quick, everyone kill it first.
Pain and suffering are all that await you.
Oh, that's not ideal at all. Okay, boss now. Should be fine.
Swap now, ideally.
Yeah, Shangri's got it. Good job.
Swap now.
Redari. Good job.
And then back to Kieran now.
I'm raging 5 seconds.
Enrich, 10.
Kieran, move out.
That's on me. It's fine, keep going.
Xalo has perished as well.
It's fine, Kiko.
Let somebody else take it.
Shangri.
Or I finish off.
Redari moving.
Yeah, nice. This was much better.
Can you battle rest Kieran and Xalo in the interim?
Yeah. So stack up now, everyone on star, please. Star, everyone on star. Only kill shit when it gets to us, please.
Please keep dispelling soul drains.
Was, but I feel like it was alone.
Hey, can I cover this?
There we go, Kieran up is good.
So much for my PvP gloves.
So next one is Redari trying to main tank this and interrupt
yes.
Anything but Den, and Den will hopefully get the power reflected by Redari.
Yeah. I've got MD on Redari, yeah. Alright, be ready.
Do anything? Do you still want Scorpid in phase 2 here?
No. Not necessarily.
You can have anything you desire.
You can also curse the Frack again.
Wait, how? Can I get a curse? Can we get a curse of tongues on, please, from one of the warlocks?
Sure.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Thank you.
No, phase 3.
That was way too fast, I couldn't even press it. Literally way too fast.
Curse of Tongue is up with 10 seconds left.
Aaron's only got it, keep going. Shangri's got it.
And new tongues.
Interrupt dead now as well then.
Just kick everything.
Runic shield or what? This.
Jade keeps grabbing it.
Okay, cool. Okay. Yeah, if spirit ship goes through, tanks get disoriented and he switches targets.
I understand.
We're probably a bit too low on DPS, but keep going anyway.
We can hit you before.
Yeah. 30 seconds, we've gone.
Just wipe it up.
Yeah, keep going. Just you got 30 seconds. Okay.
Is there anything bad if we try and interrupt Deaden even when he's trying to spell effect it?
No, not really. I mean, the thing is, it gives us 100% more damage, which would be really good.
Is it on effect CD, by the way? Like, or is it... Is a CD on their belly, but then he just uses it at any point after that. Because it's so fast. Like I'm trying to pump threat. I'm like, by the time it comes up, it's too late.
Just kick instead. Like, is spell reflecting such a big deal?
Yeah, but that's what I'm asking. Is it on a fixed CD or is it just like?
It has a CD, but it doesn't use it off CD.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah.
Let's kick it then.
Like, I just don't have enough of a threat lead to, like, be able to focus on pressing it. Like, it's just impossible. I don't have fast enough reactions for that.
It didn't help that you got the spirit checked in the start either.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I mean. I just had no threat, so I was just focusing on the threat meter, not anything else.
But if we don't get you a spirit checked in the start, you might have more time, more threat, and therefore can focus more on... Spell reflect as well.
I really don't think that resting is a viable option at any point.
I don't think so either.
He's still in combat somehow.
Yeah, somebody.
I got DI. What you made me do.
I just have to die here.
But it did not work.
How are the tanks moving out? Like, what movement are you doing when you're moving out? During phase one?
I normally just step backwards a bit. If somebody's moving in from behind into the middle, then I would just step back.
Yeah, like just slowly. Go backwards, so backpedal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
At least that was what I've been trying.
Actual fuck was that, Marius?
Rocket boots.
A plus intercept plus some weird spin thing? It looks crazy.
Friedrich, come here.
No, I just really need for 1 hit for the extra avoidance in comparison to hit food.
Okay, well, let me know. I have more.
Shankly here, and then we can go summon him.
Yeah, if this someone picks.
Sass?
Still not Mudrik level Sass though.
What is that meant to mean, is he?
Only Moonrig is allowed to have Moonrig level Sass.
I work in compare to you.
Let's get Bosco and Fuka and a good ready check.
I should be ready.
Cool. Mimic?
Sorry, I just connected.
How did the shielding work, by the way? Like, tanks when you swapped in, did you get a power ward shield instantly, or...?
I'm ready now, sorry.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, it seemed to be instant, from what I saw at least. Terms up. Hey, get down the ramp. On the star, please. No further than the star.
Keep moving by now already. Like, we still drop. Combat in the middle, remember, you can drink there, you don't have to drink here. Risky spot to stop, like if you go now.
Go.
You still have combat and can go in combat, never mind.
Bring up the totems, yeah, cool.
I'm pretty sure combat didn't start just 2 days ago only.
We could have moved down and drunk. We just gotta be more efficient.
Oh, cow has it somewhere? Bubble cow? Or just get out? You can't be too close underneath, guys.
Bad count, Kevin.
It's fine. That was actually like a welcome diversion. Hearing's gonna shoot again.
Switch.
Okay, next tank.
Shangri?
Shangri's under now. I see him. Stop going so close to the center.
Hello, melee. If this
yeah, I mean, this is just stabilized, just stabilized. Okay, like, Shangri's got it now. Enrage, so Tam needs to get it. Only okay, Tam's got it. 6 seconds of Enrage left. And then Radari goes next. Spell soul drains quickly. Okay, I'll kill it. Good job. That was better. I just gotta be close close to the center. Okay. Everyone on the star, please.
Okay, so reminder for next phase. Group 1 does the... 1, the first interrupts, and then every other odd one. Group 2 does the evens, so second, and every even one after that.
Yeah.
And group 3 just try and snipe everything.
You can have anything you desire.
Okay. Shit, that's so fast.
Yeah, I literally played a spell reflect and it was too late.
Big heals on Radar.
Plus of 10 to the south.
I mean, technically, you have a good threat lead, so.
It's not only me, but I could drop that there. But just next dead, just if you see it, kick it.
Got it.
Nice one.
Great shot there.
Shangri's got it for a sec. Ready now or not? Nice one.
It's a very nice. I like that.
Beautiful. Be careful not to kill yourselves. Alright, stuck in the middle again.
Do we have a combat rest for Jaina?
If you can do it, Shangri.
Yeah, do it before the ghosts.
Yeah, Shangri's got it. Good job.
And then now we just pop Hero and be careful with the debuff he does. Like, you get a debuff that increases your threat generated. If you get, just be fucking careful.
Yeah.
And then there's the...
The main tank won't get it, so like the off tank will need to take over main tanking most likely at this point.
Yep. And then there's some debuff on a random target that explodes for 8k once the debuff takes off. So
spiked, scored, yeah. A face away from the raid. I don't know if you said that already. Face away from the raid. So who takes it to start with, Radari?
Yeah, I'll do it, sure.
Cool. Let's go. All heroisms. Zenzia, 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 Zenzia. Aelia. Shangri.
Sonata.
Yes, me, but I don't think it's fine. It's plenty of lead.
Sonata.
Still plenty of plenty of lead.
Sonata. Sonata. Sonata.
Come on, go.
Sonata.
That's how we feel.
Shangri just takes that then.
It feels like it's better to do it, to do heroism in phase 2 than in phase 3. We have more than enough DPS for phase 3.
Yeah, phase 2, I think. Be nice to get out of that quicker.
You should still keep in mind phase 2, you damage yourself the more damage you do.
Yeah, but you also have heroism for the healers, so the more healing they do.
Yeah, but HOTS don't take faster with you.
Yeah, that doesn't really help me.
It helps me.
It really helps.
And Nairina. Nairina, show me the hero I get.
Yeah, but you should have a heroism.
I almost never have hero.
Note to self, when we get to here, the healers also need a hero if all the DPS gets
yeah.
one.
Are you going to sacrifice yours? Because...
I would sacrifice mine for Moonbrick.
Fuck off.
Sib.
I wouldn't, but I would sacrifice Momo if we can make it work.
No!
What are we discussing? Hello?
It's retardation.
But even then, the DPS, DPS-wise, we felt like it felt like we were pretty well off healing all the DPS in phase 2.
Grab him. So, all right, listen. We've got a new strategy for the boss coming up, right? We now have nine groups.
Can Nazar explain it?
We just did the same as last week. We have one group moving back. They get the debuff.
You fucking killed me, Sol! Oh, man.
Kill the fuck out. Let the man talk.
Yeah, so five people move backwards, they get the debuff, they move forward. Another five people move backward, get the debuff. We don't do the 15 people stand there, five get the debuff, move forward thing, because that runs the risk of not controlling who gets the debuff. So if you get unlucky, healers might get two times, and you don't want to have too much healer movement. So we do the same as last week, basically, with...
Warlocks
first.
Yeah,
group four first. Then group one plus Telly, instead of Kirin, of course.
Go ahead,
and then group five plus Sol for Radari.
Sheep this.
But after the second phase, we start on group four again.
Yes, you start. Yes. You reach that basically. You don't like all stacks are gone anyway, so you don't have to carry over.
I'm going group one first.
Yes.
Best group.
Maybe Flurry's in the raid, it's bad. Grab it if you can.
Let's move out from him.
It's gonna start really hurting.
So this is the thing. Kill the wolves, by the way. Like, there's still a wolf left. Wolves are hurting a lot. And then obviously this fight is pretty threat sensitive for tanks, so we'll have Radari in a group that favors him a bit more.
Yeah.
Cool. Is it possible to swap the healer for Kirin?
Yes, can do that as well. But then...
Group 1 can move at once and... Telly and Sol swap in for Davi and Kieran group 5.
Yep. I mark the leading person for each group. Like, just follow your leading person.
Telly, you had it. He hit it group 5 for you now, not group 1 anymore.
For the big boys first, but we can cleave.
Other than the group movement, the only other thing we really need to know is the difference between the two phases. So obviously, one phase we tank the boss at the side of one of the water fountains to the left, that the range can stand on the right. And the second phase, when he chooses an individual that he's going to focus on and kill, during that phase, obviously, that person needs to stand a slightly different place. So there's going to be a waterfall on the left, a waterfall on the right, and they're going to stand in the middle to the far side of the waterfall as we look at it.
Where the boss is stood now, basically.
Yeah.
There's no boss right in this room, it's next corner.
Next room.
It's the next corner, yeah. So basically, the person that gets focused is going to stand there and use anything that they've got to mitigate any damage. So Warlocks, for example, you can switch on your demon armor. You can potentially life drain if you feel that it's helping. If not, you can auto attack. You don't want to cast shadow bolts because it takes away all your mitigation during the fact you're casting.
Are you getting pushed back to hell anyway? Because he gains an attack speed buff.
So if you're going to do anything, you can wand or hit him with your sword, but you're not going to be able to shadow bolt.
So the important thing is the paladins, I would say Cal, Kieran.
Yeah, both packs, sir.
Right, wait a second.
Yeah, 1 second on these. Please, please, please.
Let's go first.
My bad.
Yeah, you can cleave.
Really need to remember to stack for the bone shields, I feel like.
You mean the behemoths?
Yeah, bone shield are behemoth, yeah. Well, almost all of the mobs are called bone shield.
I just remembered.
So yeah, Umonga mentioned there's the fail rage in phase 2 where you have to move out of the raid because you will do periodic damage to everybody 18 yards around you. And besides that, important note for the tanks, since two of them were not here last time, in the first phase you will get a stacking debuff on you that I think reduces your armor the more stacks you have, so you need to tank swap, but you can't taunt. So what you need to do is to naturally pull off threat from like your fellow tank, basically. Else they will just die due to the increasing stacks.
It also is a dot that healers need to take watch for. Like all the tanks will pretty much have a dot once phase 2 starts. The other thing he does is bewildering strikes, which I'll call blind at the target for I think 8 seconds, which obviously causes him to drop threat, and this means all the tanks will be need to be in top 3 threat at all times, so they can seamlessly tank swap, and in case a bewildering strike happens, it pushes the threat down to tank number 3. For the fell rage tank for phase 2, I would say let's just do order Cal, Kieran, Piggle. You bop the target that has the fell rage debuff when there are 9 seconds left on it, even if it's a tank.
Okay.
All the other Cal, Kieran, Piggle, yeah.
Yeah, like if you make it to a third one, it would be Piggle.
Okay.
Who's gonna be tanking first?
I would say Kieran runs.
Kieran starts.
Probably he has. He will have the highest, toughest time catching threat up again.
Yeah, it's humanoid as well, so.
So obviously pick him up and pull him straight to the waterfall on the left hand side as we're looking now.
Just there, yeah?
Yeah, yep. just there on the left hand side of that waterfall.
You want to face him into the waterfall as well.
And the person that gets selected, it can be any of us, is going to stand just in front of where the boss is now. So he's going to pull the boss over there.
Yeah.
Away from the waterfall.
The boss has some cone attack, so that's why like he should always face the tank and nobody else. And melees, something that wasn't explained last time, he will target a random melee with Fell Acid Breath. When you get that, you move to the right of the boss, so you don't hit all the other melees with it. This only matters for melee.
I think we're probably good to give this a go, unless anyone's got any questions.
The only thing I will say, and I'm not being a retard here, but the groups have changed again, right?
Right. Also?
No. Only that Telly goes to group 5 now, because we swapped Apatos with Kieran.
So Eli isn't Alia, it's Telly.
No, it's Telly, yeah.
Okay. So group 4 into group 1 into group 5 plus me plus Telly.
Yeah, and then we carry it on.
And then, no, we don't carry it on. So when we go phase 2, phase 1.
We've got 5 lots. 4, 1, 5, 4, 1. Then 4, 1, 5, 4, 1. Then 4.
Yeah, exactly, that's what I'm saying. Okay, right. Let's go then. Good chat, Monga.
Wait, where's group 6?
Fuck off, is he?
So, don't make Hunter's Mark.
Sorry.
I make Hunter's Mark.
What was that?
Me doing Hunter's Mark again. Alright, let's go.
Did he call? Hard will
crush you. Perfect position.
I
careful.
Sorry. A Shangri second is
group one move out now. Someone else needs to get threats of Kieran. Just start pressing buttons, I guess, Kieran.
Shangri's gonna get in a sec. He's higher, he's just not there yet. Okay, here we go, good.
He just got an extra stack of pepper.
Yeah, healers didn't move, group 5 didn't move out. No, we're not calling it, we're just rotating.
Felwich in the moment.
There's for group. Hey, on Apatos?
Apatos, not this direction. No,
right,
no,
stay still.
The key. No.
Alright, it's a vibe. Like, you can try and heal Shangri for it, but do not pop him.
I keep healing, man.
Warlocks, make sure you're in the right position.
Friends still with us.
For group one now?
No, Warlocks.
Group four.
Yeah, but Apatos is dead, so.
Slayer Pinky can move out for Apatos.
Who?
Slayer Pinky,
okay.
So group
one,
move one
out
now.
Group four.
This you, Slayer.
Also, both tanks are nowhere near
we don't want to hear doing this.
Group five.
Never catch the Sangrit.
I'm running your blood.
Okay,
four.
I did pump one into Radari, yeah? Shangri, stop pressing any buttons. Oh, you are?
Jeez.
Yeah, just stop doing any threat at all, Shangri. Like, just press escape. Okay, he's dead. It's fine. Okay, longer on you.
Heron now, I guess, yeah.
Okay, man, he's dead.
Okay, yeah, just swipe
it. Yeah, just kills you. Wow.
Alright, just die. We can probably res this, so if you DI someone, that'd be good.
More! I want more!
Nice one.
So just to confirm, so when Apatos died there, was that where we was meant to bop?
No. That was too early. Like, he would have, like he just died. Yeah, I'm not sure, like, maybe no inner fire, unlucky crit, like, you just need to, like, somehow keep him alive when he's dead. The bop happens towards the end, because he keeps hitting faster and faster. So you, like, wanna, like, stop the last 9 seconds basically of it and make sure, like, the reason, like, a bob obviously lasts 10 seconds, the reason we're not doing it at 10 left is if it somehow clips like the last hit through, that's not good.
Dwarfs use stone form as well.
Yeah, like all defensives, you only ability, like, the fellow rage tank needs to be alive.
It hit me there for
like the tanks and the fellow rage
7k and then another 7k.
Let's make sure as well you're not being hit in the back, right? So if you're running away, you need to be backpedaling away from the boss.
Yeah.
Or just jumping, spinning, whatever.
Freeze is a little bit of an unlucky one.
Can I mention something about that? When we wipe, can we die quicker, please? That was literally 2 minutes of, like, running around, waiting for the boss to reset. After we called the wipe.
Just die on the ramp.
After we'd already said that we had a DI, so it's just, like...
Ran around to try to kill us. I waited on him to kill me, but he took a long time.
Yeah,
just don't run away though. Just die, like, where we were standing already. Like, the running around thing is so annoying because it wastes more time now as well. Because now we have to run around to go res people. It's a huge
good
time
point. Definitely need to up our wipe game. Yeah.
I'm sorry, Tom.
To be fair, I think this is the way it's going to be on this boss. I think it's going to be a case of who does he hit? Who does he pick? Is it a Cloffy? Does the Cloffy die straight away? Is it a wipe? I think that's going to be one of those things for this boss.
This is, by the way, Nightmare Seed.
We had way too few people actually healing you, Momo, for example, this time. And I think that might have something to do with... the whole raid taking a lot of damage.
A lot of damage, yeah.
So people thought that we should
be healing the raid because there's a lot of healing to do there. But the raid isn't as threatened at that point as Momo is.
I don't really want more than me and Pinky healing up the raid, I don't think.
I mean, even Pinky wasn't healing the raid. He was on Momo straight away, spamming Lesser Healing Wave. You can always just start out focusing healing on the person who gets focused, and then you can start healing up the raid slowly afterwards, because you have long-ass time to do that.
Yeah, before the blood boils start again. Rotations were fine though, at the back with the blood boil.
I mean, I just want to say this now, probably like before we start all that, but if any shaman doesn't have like a shield on or permanently in his bag, just get one. Because every class that can equip a shield when they get their fellow age tank is super, super useful.
So, are you here?
Snarter. Let's do that for half an hour. Right, it's coming to the end of raid time. We've probably only got one go at this, as it is getting late.
Probably give it one more attempt and
yeah,
call it, unless it's like a super fast wipe. But...
Well, it's 10 o'clock at the end of the day, it's late.
How did the tanks, get a feeling for the mechanic in phase one?
Yeah, I'm gonna try and take a second because Shangri's threat is obviously too much. He can overtake any of us, whereas if he gets it, it's kind of hard, so...
Yeah.
I'm gonna try and take a second, but it was difficult to start just to, like, my threat's establishing to, like, stay second. I had to stop for it so I didn't overtake Kieran, and then... Like, threat meter seems wonky, then Kieran had a load of threat, and then everybody else overtook me, so I was like way behind. So it was very wonky start.
I mean, it probably doesn't matter if you overtake him at the start, I feel like, because
the only issue is if you like keep swapping back and forth, then the debuff is not going to drop off any of you.
Yeah,
that's why I didn't want to. So yeah, it was really, really. Scuffy.
I mean, the only question is, at least probably a question to the healers, if they can take you taking just a lot more damage during this phase.
You can also move a paladin with devotion aura into the group where he's being hit.
I mean, you can do a lot of measures, but
more than being
how fast can you do the swaps? For example, Momonga died in like a global, basically. So we'd have to do a lot of swaps in one global.
2.5-3 seconds or something.
Yeah, it's pretty quick.
Let's go, guys. Yep.
Moving up. Hard will crush you.
Hey. Group one.
Soul Fane.
Yeah. And last. Last group. Okay. First group.
Fuck it.
I don't think that's you, Abatos.
Yeah.
There you go.
Second group. Okay, last group. Okay, so Monga, Soul's Mom. The meat from your bones. Pace it away. Alright, looking good.
Everyone else, well, if you can. Let's follow the CD.
to see what it looks like, yeah. Okay, back on Changri here. I can give one to Radari here.
Warlock's in position.
And you do one after. Should go, should flick to Radari here. Be ready. Second group on Foul Blood. Whatever it's fucking called. Give another one to Radari today.
I'm out.
Okay.
Stop pressing a button, Changri. Just.
Hey, last group on the Blood Boil.
Bring your blood.
Kieran now.
Hey, first group again on Blood Boil.
Salt.
Yep.
Do you have any ammo?
Yeah, trade me. Are you Violet Eye Revered? Oh no, I don't. Oh yeah, I do. Wait.
Feather Rage too.
Hey, Piggo.
Put on a shield if you have one. From your bones. Devotion over as well if you can. Pop now too, if you haven't already.
Anybody just pop him?
It's over now anyway.
It's on Kieran here, it's good.
He has 10 okay, stacks though, so you probably want to swap.
Just gonna die.
Let Radari overtake, MD Radari if you can.
Don't have any.
Castles, you're too close, way too close.
You're instead of Renarin
hacking. You need to take him the wall, yeah. We're too.
Oh no, we're gonna work it. It's fine. I mean, we get the fight anyway, we're in the sandal today. Okay, Renarin's got it. Keep going. Time
to feed. Do we just keep the boys up?
We don't have enough fucking healing for that. Enough blood boil targets.
The only thing that's tricky is just making sure all the threats balanced.
Yeah, you said we were close, but we were close because he was
in
the water. Yeah,
it needs to be.
We had nowhere to go.
Oh, Wapa.
Okay, so just to confirm, when you get that thing on you, the big, and then he starts attacking you, at the 9 seconds. That's when I can bop myself.
The last 9 seconds.
Yeah, you can bop yourself at any time in theory, but like he just starts hitting faster and faster towards the end, so you're blocking the most damage if you do it like in the last 9 seconds. That's the idea behind it. And don't bubble, because that will remove the thing and cause him to go rampage for the raid.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Cool. We are done for today, guys. That's over time, so. Thanks everyone for coming, thanks for participating in the PTR. I think we've learnt a lot, especially all the tanks and everyone, so it's good. Some things to clean up for sure, but I guess it's just one of those things that we'll learn more about as we do it more, so.
Cheers guys, I'll catch you all later.
Yeah, thanks everyone.
Is it
bye!
Until release, by the way? Well, no,
it'll be over, so PTR will be over now, I think.
Oh, is it?
Like, it'll go down, but...
Will it?
I don't know. You said you guaranteed me it wouldn't be up today, so.
Yeah, because I was going off like a wrong post. They haven't announced anything towards like PTR going down, phase 3, season 3, like nothing. Complete radio silence. So it might just be up for like the next 2 weeks.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. But I mean, Thursday will be normal raid anyway, so let's clear everything.
Cheers, everyone. All right.
Thanks, everyone. See y'all.
Nice. Thanks.